ask you something. Do you remember what we used to do when we wanted to keep a flower, or I can say rose, with us forever, like a memory? So we used to keep inside the pages of the books and we preserve it forever. That's what we used to do. Same happens in the scientific world. Various species are there, various specimens are there. So we preserve them and keep them protected from the outer environment, and we preserve them for the future studies. So here comes taxonomic aids. Welcome back to this session where we are going to learn about the taxonomic aids like herbarium, botanical garden, museum, zoological garden, then flora, then manuals, then monograph, and a lot about it. So let's start with the herbarium first. So I have this leaf and I want to preserve it with me. So what I would simply do, I just take this book, and here I'll keep it inside the pages or between the pages like this, and it is preserved forever. These resemble to the herbarium. That means if I talk about the herbarium, so it is the storehouse of the collection of plant specimens with their common names as well as their botanical or scientific names. So herbarium files, or I can say herbarium sheets. So here I have some herbarium sheets. So you can see it here. What we do in herbarium sheets, we just collect a specimen, then we pressed it and we preserved it forever. And here you can see there is a nameplate which shows about the quality, or I can say about the details of the collection. So here you can see there is serial number, common name, botanical or scientific name, the date and time when it is collected. Alright, so this is about herbarium sheets. Thousands or millions or billions of herbarium sheets are there in the herbarium, and that's how they are preserved for the future studies. Alright, so this is about herbarium. Next we are going to talk about is botanical garden. So they are very beautiful, and this is the standard garden where many trees or plants are preserved internationally. They are internationally grown and they are kept for the preservance for the future studies. Some botanical gardens are Indian Botanical Research Institute, Lucknow, Indian Botanical Garden that is in Howrah. So this is basic concept of botanical garden. All right, now next come is museum. So many times I go to museum and I see a lot of things there. There is a scientific, historical and social collection of all the specimens or all the living organisms, or we can say some kind of fossils. So like this, here I have this specimen, and like this, plants or animals or their parts or their organs are collected. Alright, so basically when we talk about museum, this is the collection of specimen, or this is the collection of various historical things as well. So I still remember when I went to one museum in my school days, I saw many butterflies was there inside a box and they were sticked or they were pinned there. So that's how they collect various organisms or their fossils. So this was about the museum. Now, if I talk about the zoological garden, we already learned about the plants. Now, what about animals? So you have pets, right, at your home. When we talk about the wild animals, they cannot be kept at home, and also they need to be preserved, and they need a particular specific environment for their survival. So that's how zoological park is made.